Welcome you all for numerical 2 on design of helical gear. The type 2 problem where the number of teeth is known and diameter is unknown. So I have already explained about the type 1 problem where diameter is known and number of teeth is unknown. This is the type 2 where the number of teeth is unknown and diameter is unknown. Let me read the description of the problem. So this is the numerical 2. Design a pair of helical gear to transmit power of 15 kilowatt at 3400 rpm with speed reduction ratio of 4:1. Power is given, the speed n1 is given, the speed of the pinion is given, and the speed reduction ratio I is given, 4:1. Pinion is made of cast steel, 0.4% carbon untreated. So with an allowable design stress of 69.6 MPa, the gear is made of high grade cast iron with allowable stress of 31 MPa. Helix angle is limited to 26 degree. So helix angle beta is given and not less than 20 teeth are to be used on either gear. So the Z1 is given in the problem, which is equal to 20 teeth on the pinion. Suggest suitable surface hardness for the gear pair. So the given data. So the type of gear is helical gear and type of profile is given 20 degree full depth profile. Power is given 50 kilowatt. The speed of the pinion is given 3400 rpm. Speed reduction ratio is given. And also along with this, the material, the pinion is given cast steel, 0.4% carbon untreated. For that, the allowable stress sigma D1 is 69.6 MPa and gear material is given high grade cast iron, sigma D2 equals 31 MPa. So also N1 is given by using the speed reduction ratio. As you know that I is given by N1 by N2, so N2 is equal to N1 by I, so N2 is equal to N1 by I, 3400 by 4. Getting 850 rpm. The first step is identifying the weaker member. To identify the weaker member, beta is given in the problem and Z1, the minimum number of teeth on the pinion, is given 20 teeth. By using the relation I is equal to Z2 by Z1, Z2 is equal to I times of Z1. So Z2 will become 20 into 4, that is 80 teeth. So once you got the Z1 and Z2, the number of teeth on pinion and gear, we need to calculate equivalent number of teeth in the equivalents per gear and the formative number of teeth. So that Z is equal to Z divided by cos cube beta. So to find out Z1, take Z1 and beta is 26 degree. Z1 is equal to 25.74. So we need to make it round off to 28 teeth. And Z to calculate Z2, so which is given by Z2 divided by cos cube beta, Z2 equals, so it is obtained as 110.18, so that 111 teeth. This is the equivalent number of teeth on this per gear. And to calculate the Lewis form factor, so which is given by the equation, so in this case 20 degree involute is given in the problem, so that take this equation 0.154 minus 0.912 divided by Z1 and Z2. So we are designing based on the equivalent design of this per gear, so that we need to take equivalent number of teeth on pinion and equivalent number of teeth on the pinion and gear. So to calculate Y1, take Z1, to calculate Y2, take Z2. Got the value of Y1 and Y2. So calculate sigma D1, Y1, sigma D1 is known, sigma D2 is known. Calculate these two parameters. Out of these two, sigma D2, Y2 is the lesser value. The sigma D1, Y1 is greater than sigma D2, Y2. The design is based on the gear. Once you know the weakest member, that is the weakest member is the gear, so go for the module calculation, the step 2. The Lewis equation for helical gear, which is given by Mn, the normal module, which is given by 2mt Cw cos beta divided by sigma d Cv Kyz all to the power of 1 by 3. In this problem, teeth is known, to calculate y, so y is also known, it depends upon z. K is known, but Cv is unknown. It depends upon the diameter, which is unknown. Assume this value. Sigma D is known. CW, take it from the table, and we need to calculate MT. So to find M, I taken this equation. So we are calculating the normal module. Normal module is the module of helical gear measured in a plane perpendicular to the teeth. Whereas M, so Mn is equal to M cos beta, that is transverse module is the module of the gear measured in the plane of rotation. It is same as in the case of spur gear. This is a normal module in the case of helical gear. If I want the module in the plane of rotation, so that we need to find out the M once we calculate the module Mn. So here we need to take CS. If the CS is not given in the problem, so assume it as steady load, what we assumed in the previous problem, and types of services 8 to 10 hours per day, that is CS is equal to 1. And for wear and lubrication factor, assume the second case, the for scant lubrication but regular frequent inspection, take CW is equal to 1.25. Yeah, from this table, CW take it as 1.25, and calculate Lewis form factor. We know Y2 design is based on the gear, pi times of Y2. So this is the value what you obtained for form factor, 0.458. Also to calculate the torque, 9.5 into 10 power of 6 into P divided by N2, we need to multiply it with the service factor CS. That is from this table, CS is equal to 1 for steady load and 8 to 10 hours per day. So the power is known and the design is based on the gear, so take N2. So the torque is obtained as 168529.41. So okay, I told you that K ranges from 12.5 to 20. So for helical gear, take K is equal to 16. In this case, the case where the diameter is unknown, when the diameter is unknown, we can't calculate velocity. Since velocity, which is given by pi d1 n1 by 60,000 or pi d2 n2 by 60,000, where d1 d2 is unknown. So CV depends on velocity, assume CV is equal to 0.5. So we know all the parameters, 2MT and cos beta, beta is 26 degree, and CW taken it for scant lubrication, 1.25. And the CV is assumed and K is 16 and Lewis form factor, the form factor, and multiplied with Z. So that the normal module, which is given as 3.14, take it approximately equal to 4 mm. Once you got the normal module, calculate the transverse module. Mn is equal to M cos beta. M is given by Mn by cos beta. So that M equals 4.45 mm. So calculate the normal pitch, which is given by pi times of Mn. So refer the data and book for this equation. So we know Mn, the normal module, and pi. So it's obtained around 12.56 mm. The Pn is given by P, the virtual pitch, the transverse pitch into cos beta. The transverse pitch is given by Pn by cos beta. So P is obtained as 13.97 mm. So this is the case where diameter is unknown. Once you calculate the module, the normal module and the transverse module, so calculate the Z. So we know that D is equal to M into Z. D is equal to M into Z by cos beta. So D1 is equal to M into Z by cos beta. Here we need to take, in place of M, we need to take the normal module Mn by cos beta. So we know that M is given by Mn by cos beta. We know the equation for diameter, M into Z. In place of M, we need to take Mn by cos beta. So Z1 is known, Mn is known, and beta is known. Calculate D1, 89 mm, and D2. This is the value of diameter D1 and D2. Once you know the diameter, we need to calculate the velocity factor. To calculate the velocity factor, so find out the velocity, which is given by pi D2 N2 by 60,000 or pi D1 N1 by 60,000. So D2 is known, N2 is known, calculate velocity. Velocity which is between 10 to 20 to go for this equation, 15.25 divided by 15.25 plus 15.84, that is velocity. So which is obtained as 0.4905. So we got this value of CV. Calculate FT, which is given by MT by R2. MT is known, R2 is D2 by 2. So we got FT, which is equal to 946.79 newton. Once we got FT, calculate sigma D design. sigma d design, which is obtained as 20.61 newton per mm square, which is lesser than the allowable stress for gear, which is given as 31 newton per mm square. So therefore design of gear is safe. Once the design is safe, calculate the dimensions z1, z2, and then mn, normal module, transverse module, normal pitch, transverse pitch, d1, d2, a, and also along with that write z equivalent 1, z equivalent 2. Step 4, dynamic load. To calculate the dynamic load, as we already discussed, in this all the parameters is known except the dynamic load factor. So K3 is known, FT is known, velocity is known, beta is 26 degree, FT is known, and B is known, except the C. To calculate C, need to go for this table. So for velocity is equal to 15.86, that means need to go for, which is approximately equal to 15 velocity. The error is 0.0230, the error is 0.0230. So this is the error for 15.86. So for this error, we need to calculate the dynamic load factor C. Again 0.0230, so we can take for either for 0.03, so please correct it, it is 0.03. For 0.03, so 235.9, that is for cast iron and steel is given, it is given 20 degree. In the previous problem, it is given cast iron and steel with 14.5 degree involute profile, but in this case cast iron and steel is given 20 degree. And for error 0.03, the dynamic load factor is 235.9 newton per mm. So if this is the dynamic load factor for 0.03, so what is the value of dynamic load factor for E equals 0.0230? So just cross multiply by using linear interpolation. So where C is obtained as 180.88 newton per mm. Once the value of C is obtained, substitute the values of C and other all other values is known, the tangential tooth load, A, velocity, beta is known, so and the cos beta is known, all other parameters is known, substitute, so where FD is obtained as 8011.98 newton. The last step is to calculate the VR load. The VR load D1 BQK by cos square beta, which is greater than or equal to FD. So by using this equation, so we know we already calculated for FD in the previous step, which is 8011.98. So D1 is known, B is known, Q, which is given by 2Z2 divided by Z1 plus Z2, which is equal to 1.6, and beta is known. By substituting all this, which is greater than or equal to 8011.98, so that K is greater than or equal to 0.71. So we need to refer the table 12.16 for K is greater than or equal to 0.71. For K is greater than or equal to 0.71, refer the table 12.16. So that BHN for the pinion is 200 and BHN for gear is 180. Thank you.